Hey marketers, today we're mastering the Formageddon with Omnisend's A-B testing in forms. Strategic, mistake-proof, and filled with insider tips. Grab a cup of coffee, get comfy, and follow along. It's much easier to retain the information if you try doing something yourself. Well, if you're ready, let's dive in. So here we are in the Omnisend dashboard. We're going to go ahead and go into forms, and we're going to create a new form. Now what you see here is a bunch of templates with different themes and different types, but do note that only the pop-up form is allowed to be A-B tested, meaning that embedded and landing pages do not have an A-B test feature assigned to them. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on pop-up, and we're going to use this template because I like it. So here we are, and now I'm going to show you how to actually create the A-B test. So what we have here is a list of our forms, obviously, and we have this pop-up form that we have just created, and we're going to select this little drop-down and click on Setup A-B Test. Now, I will note that it is possible to also set up an A-B test through the builder itself, but the way you do it might vary because we're trying to make it more accessible. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to go through this. So let's click on Setup A-B Test, and here we are. This is this A-B settings page, and I'm going to explain what you're seeing here. So what you see here is two versions of the form that were just copied from this original form, and I'm going to stick with that. I'm going to call it original. And there were just two copies made of that. And you can change those copies the way you like, just to make an A-B test. Now, I will mention that for the time being, there are only two versions available for A-B testing. You cannot create three, you cannot create four. There is only two of them. Now, I'm going to explain what the split is. So a split is essentially a percentage of people that are going to get this version of the form. So what happens when a visitor opens your site who is not subscribed, it will get automatically assigned a certain version of this form. Let's say someone enters your website, it gets version B. Another person enters your website, it gets version A, because the likelihood of that is like 50-50. So that's very likely. So I can change the split if I don't really feel confident about, like, let's say the version A, and I will call version A and version B a bit differently. I'm going to call version A the control version, the one that you're trying to test, and the version B is going to be called an experiment. So actually I feel pretty confident with the original. I think that was pretty good. So I'm going to stick with the 80-20% split. So here we go. Now I also want to show you the formless page again. And there you go. So we have, for example, the Greg A-B test right below it, and just says pop-up. There is no A-B test assigned to it. But if we look over here, we have the pop-up with draft A-B test setup. So this is the one that we have created and the one that we're editing right now. Now, you might be wondering, if I change my mind and I no longer want to run an A-B test, is it possible to, well, cancel it, disable it? Yes, it is possible, and you can do it for the email builder, but then again, it's going to change. The way you do it might change. So I'm just going to do it through the forms list. So I'm going to click the drop down once again, A-B test, edit A-B test. And if we look over here, click on this little drop down, and we're going to click cancel A-B test. Now I will note what this is going to do is it's going to restore the form to this original version and get rid of these versions. So if you made any edits to these, just know that you are going to lose it and this will be reverted back to the original version. So since I didn't make any changes and I'm not losing anything, I'm just going to cancel the A-B test. And we are put back to the forms list with our pop-up now saying just pop-up. There is no A-B test assigned to it anymore. But since we are making an A-B test, let's go ahead and do that once again. Set up an A-B test. And here we are again. I'm going to revert that to 80-20. And notice how that also switched to 20 because 80 plus 20 equals 100. And I am going to keep the version A as it is. And I'm just going to edit the version B. So let's click on edit. And what you see here is just a pop-up form. But there is a little bit of something new that you might notice, and it is the countdown timer feature that we have added quite recently. Now what you can do is just specify a date, and it is going to count down to that specific date for all of your pop-up, well, impressions. And you can, of course, change the font to that, change the countdown color, all the things like that. And the version A does have that, same as this one. And I'm going to test if having a countdown timer is going to make any impact on my signup rate. So I'm just going to get rid of that in the version B. The version B, you can see it here. And since I have now made this correction over here, I'm going to switch back to version A just to show you that it was not changed at all, and it was only that version B that was changed. Version A, version B. And I'm also going to leave a little typo over here, and I will show you later why I did that. Let's say leave your email to get the limited deal. Let's go with that. Now, I also want to direct your attention to the targeting section, because it's really important that both versions of the form appear on the same page, because changing that might lead to incompatibility and would damage the results of the form, essentially. So I would highly recommend setting the same page for both of the versions. So I've got that in mind already, and I have this, one of our products, one of our demo pages products, which is called the World's Softest Sweatshirt, and I'm just going to copy the URL to it and add it over here. I'm going to do the same for the version A. Targeting, Pearson URL, paste. And now we are just about ready to launch the A-B test. But a little disclaimer before we do, when we do end up launching the A-B test, the original version will be erased and only the control and experiment versions will remain. So you will no longer be able to access the original version. But since we don't really care that much at the moment, we are going to go to the settings and start the A-B test. And here we go. You can see the A-B started status on the form that we have just launched, and let's just go to the website and see what kind of form we are going to get. So here we go, we got the A version, or the control version, which has the countdown timer attached to it. So let's go ahead and fill in some of the info. I'm just gonna call myself Alex at company.com. And there we go, we have filled in the form. Okay, so I got this version, but some of your visitors will get a different version, and the percentage of those users depends on the percentage that you specified when you were setting up your A-B test in the split section. Okay, so we've got the test up and running, and now what? Now, you might recall that I have left a little typo on our version B, which might impact our results because of the typo. And let's just jump into the actions and let's edit that. There we go, we update it, and the form was updated. So now why did I do that? It's to show you that it is possible to edit the form after it is launched, but I would not recommend that because it might hurt the form's readability and the reliability of the data that you receive. And now you might be thinking, what if I want to pause or temporarily disable the form? Well, it is currently not possible, and the only way to do that is to pick a winner, which I'm going to show right now. So if we go over here, and we can already see the data that was populated. So we got the split of 80-20, and of course I've got this one because it's a much more higher likelihood of that happening. So we got one view, we got one interaction, and one signup. 100%, 100%, just the perfect form, am I right? So what we can do now is we can choose the winner. And of course, that would be the control version, and the experiment has failed for us. So what's gonna happen after I choose the winner is it, as you remember, the original version is already erased, and what this is going to do is erase the losing version as well. So if I choose this, the form goes back to just the pop-up without the A-B test attached to it. So if we go over here, you can see that this is just a control version. And now you might be also thinking, what happens to the data that was attached to both of the tests? Well, it gets merged into a single entity and you can see all of the data over here. However, you will not be able to tell which form was displayed at that time. Was it the version A or the control version or the version B or the experiment version? You will see the joined information into one single entity essentially. Now, what you can also do is go back. Let's go back to the forms. Let's hop back into the same form that we have just created and A/B tested already. And what we can do is I'm gonna show you how to do it in the email builder this time. You can create an A/B test directly from the editor over here. Set it up again, and you can do it as many times as you want on as many pop-up forms as you want. You can keep using the same one or make more tests. It's really up to you. Okay, so let's quickly recap what we've learned so far. Number one, when the A/B test form is created, there are three versions of the form that coexist independently. The control or the A version, the experiment or the B version, and the original version. Two, only two form versions of A/B test can be launched at the same time. 3. Once the A/B test is started, the original version is erased. 4. It is possible to edit the forms post-launch, but it is not recommended because the changes might affect the results' consistency and comparability. 5. Pausing the A/B test is not currently possible, and the only alternative is picking a winner. 6. After you pick a winner, the data from both versions is merged in the reports, and other versions of the form are erased. All right, so knowing how to do it is great, but let's also talk about the why. By A/B testing your forms, you get the flexibility to experiment with various aspects of your pop-up forms and compare the results to achieve the most optimal result. Maybe it's the image that's throwing people off, or maybe the text is not enticing enough. Let your audience decide what they like. After all, they are the ones interacting with the form. Let me give you a few examples of what kind of tests you could try running. Number 1. Different copywriting. Test variations in the text and messaging of your forms. Number 2. Different visuals. Experiment with images, colors, and graphics. Number 3. Look and feel. Adjust both the visual elements and copywriting for a comprehensive makeover and see what sticks better. Number 4. Display settings. Test different triggers or timing for form display. Number 5. Single step versus multi-step forms. Explore whether a one-step form or multi-step form is more effective. Number 6. Contact information. Experiment with the amount of information you collect. If your customer really wants to hear from you, why limit yourself to a single channel? Number 7. Wheel of Fortune versus no Wheel of Fortune. Test whether adding gamification affects form submissions. And so on. It's really all in your hands. And I would generally suggest changing up one or two elements in the form unless it's a complete and radical overhaul of the design. And this is it. You have now mastered A/B testing for forms and you're ready to start rolling out your tests. But if you still have some questions or concerns, just make your pick. You can contact our support team via live chat through our dashboard. Drop them an email at support@omnisend.com. Or simply leave a comment below and we'll make sure to clear any doubt in your head. Oh, and we also have a helpful guide in the description to help you on your journey. See you in the next one.